Okay, good morning students. And today we will continue with the topic OpenOffice.org Writer. In a writer, it is similar to the MS Word. So many features are there, but there are some important features. In last class, previous class, we discussed in the case of formatting. There are three types of formatting: character formatting, paragraph formatting, and the page formatting. This is the three important type of formatting. It means if I type the text, so character formatting will be applicable on the selected text. Paragraph will be dependent on will be applicable on full paragraph. Okay students, tell me how we can create a new paragraph. Any student there? Here, yes, unmute yourself. Divya?
Yes, sir.
Beta, how we can create paragraph in MS Word or in Writer if we want to create a new paragraph? How we can create? Okay, I'm giving the answer. Beta, whenever we press Enter key, it means we have created a new paragraph. So remember one thing: if you are typing something and when you will press Enter key, it means you will work on new paragraph. So this is the difference. So in the case of your formatting format and then character formatting, there are, you can select the font, which you can select the typeface, size, and language. But whenever there is a color effect, a font effect, you can change color font. Then there is a capital, lowercase, title, small capitals. These things are there. Capital means all the character will be converted into capital letters, all will be converted into lowercase, all will be converted into title. Title means first character of every word will be in capital letter. Small capitals, it means you can apply these things. Overline, line above the text. Okay, strike through, line from the middle of the text. Underline, line will be at the bottom of your selected text. So ye aapke paas features hain. Position, subscript apply kar sakte ho. Super subscript means text above the baseline. Superscript, subscript means data below the baseline. Like for example, if you type x and 2, I select 2. So here format character, here superscript. So look at here x here, and if I'm typing h2o, it means 2 will be at below the baseline. So select this format character position subscript. So it will tell the font size. It is 58%, means font size will be reduced. It will be 58% of normal size. You can increase it, you can decrease this. So look at here. You can even look at here. I select the text, then click on format character. You can rotate your data. Look at here, 90 degree, 270 degree, fit to line, or scale width. It means according to our requirement, we can give. So I am taking here 90%. I click on OK button. Look at here. So this is your rotation. Next is, here is hyperlinks. You can provide the links with any file. I click on browse button, and in the desktop I select one file, one JPG file. Look at here. I select this, click on OK button. When I place my mouse on the word, now control, I will have to press control and click. And yes. So look at here. So we can provide hyperlinks in Writer. Yes, there you are.
सर आई हैव वन डाउट सर जो H2O और X2 है तो सर उनके 2 बेस में कैसे गया H2O का
लुक एट हियर बेटा वेरी सिंपल फर्स्ट आई टाइप हियर X2 आई टाइप हियर X2 एंड यू विल हैव टू सेलेक्ट 2 and then click on format, click on character formatting, then click on your position, then superscript. If you want to place your data above the baseline, this is superscript. If you want to place your data in to the baseline, this is called subscript. Look at here. The area clear? Okay, beta. Now next is, I select the text format, character formatting. There is a background. You can set the background color of your selected text. You can take here, field color, look at here. So these are different character formatting. You must know the TAM names. Aapko TAM name pata hona chahiye. Font, font effect, position, hyperlink and background. These are the different tabs of a character formatting dialog box. Now paragraph. So paragraph is a complete. Whenever we will press enter key, new paragraph will be created. So this is a complete paragraph. I click anywhere. No need to select the data. I click on format, click on paragraph. So look at here, indentation and spacing. We can apply indentation, spacing, line spacing is there. Indentation is the extra space between the margin and your text. You can apply this. Alignment, right, left, center, justify. Text flow is here. Outlining and numbering, we will discuss later on. We can set a bullet list or numbering list. Drop cap. This is very important. Look at here. I click on display drop cap, whole word or single character? Whole word. Okay, look at here. So this is the border. We can apply the border to the text paragraph. Look at here, border of your paragraph. So there is a page formatting, it will be applicable on page. So look at your page style, letter, it's A1, A4, legal. There are different size of page papers. So we can apply this according to your requirement. Then background color of your page. So no need to select the data, any contents. Header, if you want to apply header and footers, later on we will discuss these. Page border, which side you want to see. The color of the border. So look at here. Then you want your, if you want to divide your page into multiple columns, look at here. Two columns, three columns like this. So these are the different things. Now next is, in your writer, we can add some graphics, some more features. For example, table. So table is a organized way to display your data, to represent your data. So in case you want to insert table, here is a table menu. Click on that. Click on insert. Here is a shortcut. There is also a shortcut key, control plus F12. If I press control plus F12, a dialog box will appear. Here, name of the table. By default, it will be table 1, table 2, table 3, like this. You can give the name. How many columns and how many rows you want? By default, it is 2x2 table. Two rows, two columns. So you can increase it or you can decrease it like this. So whenever you will insert the insert table, insert toolbar will appear in your screen. So second method is click on table, click on insert, click on table, click on insert table, insert table. Shortcut key is control plus F12. Another way, click on insert and then click on table. Another method, in your toolbar, standard toolbar, there is a table button. So you can click on that table and then select number of rows and number of columns you want. So these are the different methods. Now in this, suppose I type here row number, you will use tab key to go to the next cell. And if we want to go to the previous cell, you will have to press shift plus tab. If you will use tab, you will go to the tab key, you will go to the next cell. Look at here. Okay. And if you press shift plus tab, you will go to the previous cell. Next is, in this table, you can type the data, and after that, there are so many features are there, like you can insert a new row, you can insert new columns, you can merge the cells, you can split the cells, so many things are there. I'm going to discuss these features. Suppose marks of first student and second student book equal, for example, it is 50 here, 50. So in place of typing 52 times, we can merge the cell. How we can merge the cell? Look at here. Select both cell. After that, in table toolbar, there is one button, merge cells. So click on that. Look at here. Second method. Select cells, click on table, click on select cells, click on table, click on merge cells. So look at here. Next is select the cells, right click, and in cells, shortcut menu will appear. In cells, in click on merge. So three methods. First is select the cells and click on table, and then click on merge cells. Second way is select the cells and in table toolbar, merge cell button is there. And last one is select the cells and right click. A shortcut menu will appear. Click on cell and merge. Next is split. It means divide your cell into multiple rows or columns. So look at here. I select, I click on first cell, one cell, and then click on here is split cells. So split cell, how many cells you want? I want three cells horizontally or vertical. So I need a vertical split. I click on OK button. Look at here. So this is your choice. In other ways, right click and click on cell and click on split. Again, horizontally and vertically, you can apply splitting. Next is click on any cell, table, split cells. So three methods are there. One is table menu, table, split, then split cells. Second one is in a table toolbar, there is a split cell button is here. Third method is click on the cell and right click and then click on cell and then split. Next is we can also insert new columns and new rows. But remember one thing, whenever you are in the last cell of your last row, if you press tab key, new row automatically added. Look at here. But there are some other methods. Look at here. If I need here admission number before marks, click on any cell in the column, click on table, click on insert. Here is columns. So how many columns you want? I need one column before or after. This is your choice. Whether you want to insert the column before the select, after the selected column or before the selected column. So you will have to select, position before or after. So I am doing here before. Okay, so look at here. And if you want to insert row, click on an click in any cell and then click on another method to insert column is click in any cell and there is insert column button in table toolbar. Table toolbar will appear when you will click on any table, it will automatically appear in your screen. So look at here, insert columns. So it automatically insert the column after the selected column. So, and another way is right click on any cell and click on rows and then click on insert new row. Row will be inserted if you click on column and then click on insert, new column will be inserted. So again, three methods are there with the help of table menu. Second one is with the help of table toolbar. And third method, that is right click in any cell, a shortcut menu will appear and click on row in case you want to insert row and click on column if you want to insert column and then click on insert. In the same way, we can also delete the columns and rows. Click on any cell and then click on table, click on delete, click on row or columns and table. If we want to delete the table, click on table. So next, look at here, I am going to delete the row. So look at here. And same thing we can then with the help of, we can apply with the help of table toolbar. In table toolbar, there are two buttons, delete rows and delete columns. And if I right click in any cell and click on row and delete any row and click on column and then click on delete to delete the column. So these are the three different methods. Next is, we can make our table more attractive by applying auto formatting features. So look at here. I click in any cell and in table toolbar, there is auto format. There are preloaded designs are there. So look at here. These designs are there. Select your design and click on OK button. So look at here. So this feature is called auto format. So for auto format, we can apply with the help of menu. We can apply with the help of toolbar. So look at here in a table toolbar. There is a auto format button. Then if you right click in any cell and then click on table. So there is a background color is there, border is there, different features are there. Okay, students, next is, look at here, in any cell, there are two type of alignment, vertical and horizontal. We know that horizontal alignment is right, alignment, left alignment is there, justify is there, center alignment is there, but vertical alignment, top, middle, bottom. So look at here. If I click on any cell, then in a table toolbar, there is your vertical alignment, top, center, bottom. So these things are there. Now, in the case of your table toolbar, there are different buttons are there, because in exams, there are some questions like name any four buttons available in table toolbar. Look at here. First is table button. Here we can insert the table. Then line style. Different type of styles are there. It is a different styles of border. Then line color means border color. Okay. And border style, whether all the lines or right lines, vertical lines are there, horizontal lines are there, different styles are there. Then background color. Then split cell, optimize, top, center, bottom. These are vertical alignment. Then insert row. There is insert column, delete row, delete column, auto format, table property means table property dialog box will appear. Next is you can apply auto sum. Look at here. I click here. Here is 1, 2, 3, 4. If I click in this cell, look at here. Here is a sum. Whenever you will click on auto sum, your formula will be there. So I use here equal to sum in bracket. I select the different cells and close the bracket and then press enter key. So there are some problem due to your format. I am inserting another table. Ten, 20, 30, and 40. I click on cell, last cell, auto sum, then click on apply. So look at here, 100 means 10 plus 20 plus 30 plus 40. Different functions you can apply.